Hello and good morning. So for today, I'm going to show you how to perform user authentication in your Android application using Google Authentication Scheme. So this is by far the easiest way to implement user authentication in your Android application. So the documentation is available on the Google Developers documentation online. So you can follow it through this URL. So let's see the finished result. So the finished result is depicted in this emulator. So in order to sign in your application to access the secret place or the authentication part of your application, you only need to click sign in. So click here. And then it will show the authentication screen. So similar also to this application. So if you have already authenticated, when you click in the sign in logo or the sign in button, it will display your display name, username, and then your email, right? Your display name and your email or your user's email. So this is what we are going to do today. So we are going to implement the user authentication using the Google Authentication Scheme API. So let's start with our code. So start by creating a new project. And then go to the empty activity and then click next. And then type in your application name. So you can put in sign in demo. And then remember your package name because it is important later. So for this activity, we will be using Java. So select Java. And then you can also select your API. Okay, you can use any form of API that you like. But I advise you to leave out with the default setting. That is Marshmallow. Minimum SDK Marshmallow. But if you want to publish it to your to the Google Play or Google Play Store, you have to select API 28. Okay, next go to finish up the setup. Alright, you will be displayed by this screen. Okay, so far so good. So if you go to this URL, okay. If you go to this URL, you will be greeted with this website. Okay, try in sign in for Android. Okay, we are not going to do this, okay, but we are going to skip to start integrating. So because I find it most of the student inexperienced in doing programming inside the Android application, that's why I decided to create this video. Here is the prerequisite. So far you may already do not have problem with this prerequisite. Okay, and then the guide advise you to modify the build Gradle inside your Android application. So to add Google and then to add this dependency. So you can copy this line to be pasted inside your Android setting. So the website says that okay, you have to go to the project top level build Gradle. So in order to access that, you have to click on your Gradle script over here. So this is the project level. So project level, build Gradle will be labeled as project. So click here. So ensure Google would be included. So the word Google would be included under repositories. Okay, then it is fine. And then you go to the application level. So in the application level, okay, it is denoted with the label module. Okay, with the sign in demo app. Okay, the word app would be written here. So double click this. And then you go at the bottom, okay, under dependency. And then you paste implementation. com.google-android-jms-play-services-auth. Okay, authentication 19.0.0. Okay, the number of the version may change in the future. But at the time of the video, it is still 19.0.0.0. Okay, next. Okay, you have to create your Google API console project. So to do this, you have to configure a project or you have to create your own Google console account. So if you do not have a Google console account, you have to create it at the Google console account on your own time. But for now, I'm going to show you what my Google console account project would be displayed look like. Okay, I have a testing project. Okay, I will have to click on the testing only where you are calling from. Okay, select Android application because we want to use the Android application to call the Google sign-in API. Okay, and then the package name. Right, already filled in because I've already tested it this. So, how to get your package name? So, in order to obtain your package name, you have to go to the manifest, right? And then androidmanifest.xml. Okay, double click this, and then your package name is written up here. Okay, package. So this is my package name. Your package name may vary. Okay, just copy this, and then you paste it in the website. And then you have to get the SHA signing certificate. So if you are testing or debugging your application, you have to use the key tool or key store pass to the your key store file. So if this would overwhelm you, I'm going to show you a shorter way to access your key tool and key store. To access your key store, you have to open a CMD, okay, command line. Okay, open a command line and then you cd to your application directory. So what is your application directory? So you go to android.android, right? CD Android. So here you dir. Okay, you can find your debug key store over here. Okay, that solve one problem. And then you have to run the key tool, right? The key tool application. Okay, writing the key tool application is simple as long as you know the DOS command line. So if you do not know about the DOS command line, then I will show you a shortcut. So usually it is stored in under program file. So you type program and then you press tab. And then you delete the code and then press slash type JA. You go to Java and then you type JRE. Alright, doesn't matter what type of your Java runtime as long as it is a Java. And then you type slash, okay, bin, okay. Okay, press tab again, and then delete, okay, backspace, or delete the code. And then type key tool. Alright, and then space, dash key store. And then the name of your key store, that is debug.keystore. Alright, like here. And then, let's see what else that it is listed. Okay. Okay. Dash list dash V. Okay. Just type it. Dash list dash V. Okay. Dash list. Sorry. Dash V. Okay. Press enter. Okay. No command provided. All right. This is odd. All right. I didn't space up, okay, the dash list, okay, press enter, and then it require you to type a key store password, and then press enter. Alright, after you have pressed enter, so look at the line SHA-1, okay, secure hash algorithm 1, SHA-1, okay, copy this, right, okay, to copy this, you only have to highlight, and then press right click. Right. And then go to this Shaw signing certificate, right click, and then paste as plain text. And then you press create. And then download this client configuration. Okay, and then allow. So download it. And then client ID. For the client ID, you only need to copy this file. Okay, copy this text. Okay, ensure that you save the client ID in a secure location. You can save it in Notepad. Okay, client ID for Google authentication. And then press enter. And then at the same time, also save it in your Google. Right, in your Google source code for safekeeping. Alright. Okay, that is relatively easy. So next, what you are going to do? Right, you go and add the sign in. Okay, start integrating. Alright. Okay, this guide asks you to create a sign-in option, GSO, new sign-in option builder. So this is relatively easy. You only have to copy and paste it inside your Google application, Android application. Okay, paste. Okay, the thing is that you have to press sync in order for this red color to be imported. Okay, after you press sync, you press alternate enter, so it will be imported. So fairly easy, but in order to make it much more robust, you have to declare GSO, this Google sign in option, at the top of your class. So just copy this. All right, ensure that it is at the top of your class. All right. Okay, this is enough, right? Okay, GSO. So it can become something like this. So, and then follow again this website, right? Okay. Up until this part, most of the student cannot do. In fact, most of the student that I found, they do not look after this documentation carefully, or they didn't read about this documentation carefully. Most of them would try to use Firebase sign-in. Okay, Firebase sign-in. I don't know why most students would incline to use Firebase sign-in, because this is much more easier to use. So, up until now, I do not have a clue. So, I don't know why. I don't know how and why and who advised them. And even when they come it to me, asking me how to do a sign-in, I would decline to show them, because I felt that this is more like a spoon-feeding exercise. So, instead, I would rely to this official Google documentation. All right. Okay, let's copy this. Okay, let's continue and copy this this line. All right. So you can go ahead and follow this documentation, or you can follow this video. So it is easy. So just alternate enter. And then this one, you will find it, find that you will be faced with a problem. Okay, you cannot, okay, alternate enter this. Okay, this is because the documentation assume that you know something basic about Java. So, the things about Java is that you need to declare this variable. So, if you want to create a variable, you have to, or an object, you have to prefix this with M. And then the name of the class. So the name of the class is Google Sign In. Okay, like this. And then you put your M, Google Sign In. Okay, and then this will be imported. Okay, Google Sign In Client. Sorry, Google Sign In Client. Alright, the name it is Google Sign In Client. So alternate enter this. So this will become valid. Okay, no more red squiggies. Okay, next, you have to check for an existing sign-in user. So what is meant by existing sign-in user? It means that when you are creating your application, sometimes the user have already signed in. Okay, if the user already signed in, then it means that, right, the user should be forwarded to the secret part of your application or to the authentication part of your application. Okay, just like this demo. So if the user have already signed in, so when you open the application, it should be forwarded to this secret place or tempat rahsia. Okay, secret place. And then it would display the name of the user and then the email of the user. Okay, as easy as that. So if you are much more experienced, you can put in the photo of the user, which I will not cover right now. Okay, because I think you haven't had enough experience yet with Google sign in. Right. But if the user are not signed in, okay, what they will see is this button, and then when they click sign in, they will be forwarded to the sign in page from the Google. Just as easy as that. Right, next, what we will do is to get the information on the last sign in user. So you have to copy paste this, right? Okay, you can also copy paste this. Okay, go to the source code and then check for existing Google sign in. And then you have to import this class. By now, you may have already seen or may have already noticed that I always copy the command. Okay, why I copy the command? Ni bukan saja seronok-seronok nak copy command. Okay, there is a reason why I copied the command. Because the command contain the technical information about the command. So the technical information is that if the user is already signed in, the Google sign-in account will be non-null. Kalau user tu dah sign in, maka account ni akan jadi bukan null. Tapi kalau dia tak sign in lagi, account ni akan jadi null. So what happen? So you have to check for the account if the account is null. So to check for the account is null, you can type here if account equals to null. Okay, this is not included inside the documentation because the documentation thinks that this is silly. Because anybody who program Android already know Java. So if you are weak in Java, you may not realize this. So that's why I'm showing you this code. Okay, this is this came from my own opinion. You have to check for now. Okay, you have to check for now. Because when it's now, it means that the user haven't signed in yet. Ataupun bahasa kampungnya, user tak sign in lagi. Belum. Okay. Kalau now. So what happened? So you have to display a notice. So the easiest way to display notice, you can use toast, which you have already covered before this. Okay. Okay, you can put here, please sign in with Gmail. Okay, please sign in with Gmail account or Google account. Okay, it is almost interchangeably. The langshot.show. Okay, that is easy. Okay, what happened if else? Okay, else, it means that user already signed in. So, show the secret page, right? Okay, you can test this theory right now. So you can press play or run. And then we can see it through the page. Okay, please sign in with your Gmail account. Means that the user haven't signed in. Okay, all right. Sign in demo. Okay, replay back. Okay, please sign in with your Gmail account. All right, ensure that this would be displayed. Right, let's see on the documentation. Okay, what is update UI? Okay, update UI ni sebenarnya tak wujud. Kamu kena buat sendiri. So, you have to do it yourself. So, this is my implementation of update UI. Okay. Okay, this is the implementation of update my own update UI. The easiest one to show you. Because if I implement it using the production code, I don't think that you can follow it effectively. So, I simplify this code. Okay. To check for the account now, if the account is null, means that the user haven't signed in yet, so you have to sign in. Else, the user would be forwarded to the secret page, which we haven't done it yet, and we will get back to this later. Okay, next, we need to create a sign-in button. Okay, creating a sign-in button is simple because you have already done the previous lab. Okay, if you remember back the previous lab about how to convert how to create a unit converter, right? Okay, up here. Okay, the link is up here. Ding. So you have to see the about the sign in button right here. Okay, you have to copy this and then create it inside the layout, right? The layout is under REST. Right. Okay, click the activity main. Okay, delete the hello world. Or you can also use this hello world. Okay. Okay, you can also use this hello world. Okay, let me zoom it. Okay, for you to see. Okay, just according to the design. Okay, so you can see this clearly. Alright. Okay. Okay, this hello world. Okay. Welcome to BMI BMI Weight Watcher. Okay, something that your application that you want to create. Alright, Weight Watcher. Okay, Weight Watcher. Okay, next. We need to include the sign in button. So go to the code. Okay, click over here, code. Okay, under text view, over here, paste, okay, this. Okay, so the sign in button will appear. So, place your sign in button over here, and then link this with the welcome to Weight Watcher. And then link this to the left. And then link this also to the right. So it will be centered. Okay, the sign in would be centered. Okay, then press run app again. Okay, like this. Okay, then you will have your sign in button. Right, welcome to Weight Watcher sign in button. But the sign in button has no functionality yet. Okay, to do this, you have to read more on the documentation. In order to ensure that the sign in button have functionality, you have also to remember back what we have already learned during our previous lab, that is in the basic unit converter video. Okay, you have to create a sign in button which find view by ID, right? So to do this is simple. Okay, you can either copy and paste this, okay, inside your code. Okay, you can type it or you can copy paste this. Okay, ensure you create this under set content view or anywhere that you like, but must be under set content view. Okay, either here is okay, or you can also put it under here. Okay, doesn't matter. As long as it is under set content view, okay? Press alternate enter, okay, to import class. Okay, then you get the sign in button. And then just like your basic unit converter, you only have to type implements on click listener. Okay, like this. And then you press alternate, enter also to implement the method. Right? When you implement, you have to implement the method. So the method will become like this. Okay, on click view. Right, let's follow the documentation. Okay, it asks you to set the on click listener. Okay, this. Okay, very simple. Just under here. Okay, just type in sign in button, set on click listener. Okay, this. Okay, just like your basic unit converter lab. Okay, just like your basic unit converter lab. Okay, this one will ensure that when your user click the button, okay, click the button like this, okay, the signal will be sent on the on click listener, okay, to over here, and then it will pass over here. So from here, you can use a switch, okay, view.get ID, alright, and then create here. And you can type in case r.id.signin button. Alright. Okay, then you look at the flow. Okay, we have already done this. Switch v.getid case signin button sign in. Okay, this one it advises you to create method, okay, right, a method inside the class for handling sign in, but you can also type in direct, okay, type in directly, okay, you can ignore this or type in directly, right, or go over here and then just paste it directly, okay, and then type in break. Okay, simple and easy. And then here intent, just import the intent. Okay, intent also we have already covered in the previous lab. Okay, just import class. So RC sign in is just what we call as final. Okay, final variable. Okay, as a final variable. Right, final variable means you can put in any code. Okay, any number. So I choose 10. Alright. Okay, final variable means a variable that cannot be changed at all. Okay, here. Right. Next, it will handle the sign in. Okay, next you have to create a public on activity result. So you can type this or you can copy this, right? You can copy this. Okay, you can just copy this. And then, okay, from here, okay, you can see the curly braces. Okay, you put this under, inside the class. Okay, inside the class. Okay, this one is method. This one is switch. Okay, if you look at the highlighted curly bracket. Okay, this one is under inside on click. So you paste it here. So inside the class. Okay, sign in, you replace with this number 10. And then task, you just import this. Alright. Okay, this is fairly easy. So handle sign in result means that you have to create what we call as another method. Okay, this one is a private method. Okay, private method is similar to public method, except that it cannot be called outside from the class. So please be careful. Look at here, right? This is inside request code. This is inside on activity result method. So we can create a new method over here. So paste here. Okay, this one is if sign in successfully, update UI. Okay, you can delete this. Okay, because we are not going to implement update UI. And then you can put API exception. And then log, you can input log. Okay, update UI also, you can comment this or delete this. Okay, because we are not going to implement this yet. Okay, tag. Okay, tag mean for you to make it easier for you to find the error if you are debugging. So usually tag ni, you can put in any tag. Okay, for me, I like to delete this. Okay, or you can specify the tag at the top of your class as a final string. Okay, as a final string. So for me, sometimes I just like to put here this keyword. Okay, alamak. Okay, things cannot work. So alamak. Okay, just find the keyword that are not usually present in the English language. That, so that when something happen, you can search it inside your logcat. Okay, nanti bila ada error, nanti dia akan keluar ni. Alamak. Okay. Alright. So what will happen here is that things are signed in successfully over here. It will show the authenticated UI, right? It will show the authenticated UI. Okay, this comment has already explain. Maksudnya kalau benda kita dah sign in, dia akan tunjuk kat kita tempat rahsia. Okay, tempat rahsia. Okay, kalau tak boleh, dia akan masuk kat sini exception lah. Exception mean tak boleh sign in. Apa yang kita nak buat kalau tak boleh sign in? Okay. Maksudnya kita boleh letaklah apa teks kat sini kan. Kata tak boleh sign in. Kita letak teks kat sini. Contact this. Amak tak boleh sign in lah. Okay. You can put in any other text that you want to show to the user. Alright. Fairly easy. Very simple. Okay, ni maksud dia. Okay. Buka aktiviti baru yang rahsia tadi tu. Okay. Okay, kita akan buat satu aktiviti rahsia. So, before kita buat aktiviti rahsia, kita akan test dulu. Alright. Make text. Okay, this. Okay. Okay, this one kita akan type kat sini lah. Type kat sini. Okay, already sign in. Okay, already sign in. Right, and then put here toast.langshot.show. Right, so you can test this activity. And then you click sign in. Alright. And then it will display already sign in. But it does not forward you to the activity rahsia. So kita kena buat lah activity rahsia ni. And then kita akan create satu intent untuk ke activity rahsia. Okay, to do that. Okay, just create a new activity over here. Okay, you can click on the gallery. Okay, you can select empty or any basic activity. Just create empty activity. Okay, because it will make it easier. Okay, you put a rahsia activity or anything that you like. Okay, I'm dumbing this down. Okay, I'm making this dumb because to make it easier for you to follow. Okay, so it become activity rahsia like this. So, you go to the activity rahsia layout. Okay, I'm going to zoom this a little bit. Okay, put in a little text. Okay, a little text view. Okay, this one to signify the name. Okay, the name of your account. Alright, the name. Okay, name, TV name, sorry. Okay, TV name. Okay, refactor this. Okay, you can rename this as name. Okay, template name. Oh, okay. And then you make sure that you anchor this left and right. And then on top here, and then below here, and then you create another text view over here for email. Right, TV email. Okay, refactor it. Okay, and then go to the text. You type here template email. Okay, as a dummy text. And then you go to left. And you go to the right. And then you link this. Okay, you link this to template name. Oh. Okay, you link this to the template name. And you can bring it down however you like. Okay, like this one. All right. Okay. And then you go to rahsia, activity rahsia. Okay, likewise. Okay, you type in text view, TV. Name equals to text view. Text view. Find view by ID, r.id.tv name. And then text view. Email equals text view. Find view by ID, r.id.tv email. Alright. Simple. Alright, simple. Okay, then go to the main activity. So this is what happened if you have already sign in. So bila kita sign in, dia akan pergi ke tempat rahsia tadi ni lah. Tempat rahsia ni tadi. So apa yang kita perlu buat adalah kita perlu tekan enter kat sini. Kemudian kita akan start intent lah. Okay, this one I've already show this in the list view. Okay, list view lab. So kalau sesiapa pernah follow list view lab, so kalau tak pernah memang kamu tak akan faham lah benda ni, susah nak follow. But if you have already follow the list view lab, the URL over there, ding, right? If you follow the list view lab, where you click the state name, and then it will display the state name on the next activity, then this knowledge is very familiar to you. Okay, just type it intent this, and then you put here rahsia activity.class. Okay, rahsia activity.class. Okay, where do I get this? I get this from here. Okay, rahsia activity. Okay, what do I do next? Okay, intent. Okay, and then fairly simple. So intent, you can put extra. Okay, put extra name. Okay, because you want to retrieve the name of the account. Okay, and then you remember this account. Okay, account. Okay, type your account that, then get display name. Right? Get display name. Alright. Okay, fairly simple. Okay, why it is. Okay, display name may produce null pointer exception. But we are not going to handle this now. Okay, kita takkan handle benda ni lagi lah. Nanti kita akan cuba buat a new lab where we can see how we are going to handle this null pointer exception. So, email. Okay. Account.get email. Okay, you have already put this extra, and then you can start activity. Start activity, type here intent. Okay, everything is as simple and as easy like what we have already learned during the list view activity. Okay, during the list view activity. Sama saja. Kalau kamu tengok list view activity yang sebelum-sebelum ni, sama saja proses dia. Alright. Okay, now let's try this on the new emulator on the Pixel. Okay, press play. Okay, this is a Pixel emulator, and then press sign in. Okay. So it will be forwarded to sign in. So I will sign in with my account, right? Okay, Gmail account. Okay, I'm pressing next. Alright, then it asks me to input the password. Okay, using two factor. And then I'm putting my number. Alright, and then it asks me many things because this is a new phone. Okay, basically this is a new emulator phone. Okay, then I agree. Okay, and this, that, everything in that Google has handled for me. And then let's see if it's forwarded. Alright, dia akan forward kat tempat rahsia. Okay, this is the secret. Okay, the secret area. So, kenapa dia tak keluar nama? Template name and template email. So, I'm going to show you how to input your name and email over here. So, if you press back, just click sign in and then it already signed you in. Okay, you press it, it show you already signed in. So, very easy and simple to sign in inside your own application. So, I'm going to show you next how to change the template name and template email to your name and your email. Okay, ini sebab benda ni simple saja. Okay, this one also a prerequisite of your ListView lab activity. Okay, ListView lab activity, ingat balik kan? ListView lab activity. So, bila kita ingat balik ListView lab activity, dia mudah. Kita kena hanya type get intent. Okay. Get string extra. Okay. Ingat balik apa dia kita bubuh tadi. Dia punya key dia name. And you put dia string name. Okay, string name. And then string email. Okay, get intent. And then get string extra. You put here email. Okay, ensure that the key would be the same like you put in inside the main activity. So, the key name, key email. Okay, all the spelling, all the characters must be correct. Okay, in this case, sensitive. Java and C and Python, all of that is case sensitive. Okay, ensure that everything is accordingly. Okay, then you go over here and then you type TV name. Okay, here. Okay, to display the name. Okay, set text name. Okay, this thing also you have already learned in the basic unit converter activity. Right, at least you have already know about that. Okay, email. Alright. Okay, rerun back the application. Press sign in. And then your name and your email is displayed. So, what missing is only the sign out button, right? Apa yang missing sekarang ni adalah sign out button. So, what we are going to do now is, kalau macam ni user tu nak sign out lah. Okay, nak sign out. And then, satu lagi yang problem adalah bila kita masuk dalam application ni, bila kita sign in, already sign in, dia masih lagi tunjuk sign in. Bila kita tekan sign in, baru dia masuk ke dalam activity. So, kita nak avoid. Kita nak cuba avoid button ni lah bila kita dah sign in. Right, kan? Bila kita masuk ni, kita terpaksa tekan sign in baru boleh masuk ke sini. Walaupun kita tak masukkan password. Right, walaupun kita tak masukkan password. So, bila kita back, kita terpaksa tekan lagi sign in. Kan? Nampak tak dalam ni? Sign in demo bila kita start the application walaupun application tu baru. Right, kita tekan kat sini. Alright. Tekan ni, sign in. Okay, dia masuk. So, apa yang kita nak buat adalah kita nak cuba avoid benda ni. Okay, kita nak cuba avoid this screen. Because we have already signed in. So, ingat tak balik apa yang dipanggil sebagai mobile user characteristic? It means that every user is identifiable. Means that setiap mobile application, dia tak sepatutnya tunjuk sign in screen setiap kali user tersebut menggunakan application. Betul tak? So, because every user is identifiable and then every application is identifiable. So, we want to avoid this. So, in order to avoid this, you go back to the main activity and then go up until here. Okay, remember back the else. Alright, else. User already signed in, so show the secret page. Right, show the secret page. So, how do you want to show the secret page? So, you go down here. And then, just copy back this line. Alright. Copy back this line under here. Or you can put this line inside the dedicated method. Ataupun kita boleh create satu method. Macam tadi, dia buat method update UI. Dan dia buruh semua benda ni dalam method update UI. Okay, as simple as that. And then press press play. Okay, dia terus masuk ke sini. Okay, perasan tak? Dia terus masuk ke sini. So, saya akan cuba tutup. Okay, run balik application, sign in demo. Okay, dia terus masuk ke sini. Dia tak tunjuk dah. Sign in activity. Right. Okay, dia dah tak tunjuk sign in button. So, what left over here is we need to create a sign out button. So, macam mana nak create sign out button? So, kat sini tak ada kan? So, kita kena tekan kat sebelah ni, sign out user and disconnect app. So, firstly, you have to create a sign out button lah. Sebenarnya, you have to create a sign out button or you have to create a sign out menu. Okay, dua-dua boleh. Sign out button ataupun sign out menu. Okay, either way is it can be done. So, you go to the rahsia activity. Okay, as simple as this. Okay, go to the rahsia activity. Because kat rahsia activity ni baru kita boleh create a sign out button. Okay, go to here, activity rahsia. So, create a button. Oh, so button dia color purple. So, a purplish button. So, let's say that you have a button. Right? Oh, saya salah link. So, kalau salah link, kita boleh delete. Okay, let's say that kalau kita linkkan dia kat sini. Ataupun kita padam. Okay, kita buat ni sebagai what you say as Fitts law. Okay, remember back about Fitts law. What you say about the Fitts law. Okay, button. Okay, the text of the button. You put a sign out. Okay, easy. And then the button over here, you can put your button or you can put your sign out. Alright. Okay, refactor this. Okay, another thing is that, remember back about the Fitts law, you have to make this as wide as possible to make sure user would be easy to click this. You have to modify. You can put it fill parent. Can fill parent like this. Alright. You have a sign out button. So, nampak macam Yahoo kan? Warna purple. So, next, what we have to do is to go to the code. Sorry, it's not this code, but this rahsia activity code. Okay, find view by ID. r.id.signout. Okay, good. Put here button. Sign out equals button. Import class and then you implement this as what? Right, you implement this as on click listener and then you press alternate enter, implement the methods and then you put here sign out dot set on click listener this. Right. Okay, here you type in switch v.getid and then case r.id.signout. Afterwards, you have to refer to here, okay, sign out. Okay, you have to create a okay, you have to create the method over here. Or, you can just type in this. Okay, type in this. Okay, you have to create this method also can. Okay, copy paste the method. Sign out. Okay, type here sign out. Okay, break. Okay, it is red because we haven't implemented this. Okay, and then you have to be careful. Okay, look at here, this should be an inside switch, this should be inside on click, and then paste the method over here. So, I am Google Sign In Client is in red, Because you haven't declared this inside this activity. So to declare this inside activity, you have to type in Google sign in client. And then M, Google sign in client. Okay, like this one. Right. Okay, and then this would become, okay, no longer. Okay, no longer red. Okay, and then public void on complete listener. Okay, on complete listener, you have to import this. Press alternate enter. Okay, also import this and then import the task. So on complete, and then what you need to do is only type in finish. Okay, type in finish. That's all. And then if you want to put in the toast, you have to type in this. Okay, this user sign out. Or you can also put the name. Okay, the name of the user. So the name of the user. Okay, like this one. Okay, name. That's all email. Okay. Email of the user. Okay, sign out. Okay. Here it become red because you haven't declared this string email or string name. So in order to do that, you can type string name email like this one. Declare it as public global variable. And then you delete this. Okay, this is just basic Java. So here. And then here it will become, and then you put a show. Okay, show. Cannot resolve method. Okay. This one, this would become rahsia-activity.class. Or you can type in get application context. Okay, like this. You cannot type this, but you have to type in get application context. Right, and then finish. So finish means that it will close the rahsia activity. Okay, then you still have problem because Google sign in haven't been initialized yet. So you need to initialize Google sign in. Okay, sebab kita hanya declare tapi kita tak initialize. Tiba-tiba kita type sign out. So ini akan jadi satu problem lah. So untuk initialize dia, kita kena pergi ke bawah ini. And then pergi balik ke main activity, kita tengok macam mana kita nak buat balik sign in. So kita copy ni, dua ni. Okay. And then dia akan jadi satu sign in. M Google sign in client. Okay, dua ni. Okay, these two line is important. Okay, paste. And then this GSO, you can just go ahead and type in Google sign in option. And then it should, this should work. Okay, theoretically this should work. Okay, and then you just press play. Okay, let's see if there is an error. Right, sekarang ni dia keluar sign in demo kan. Okay, ada sign out kat bawah. Kita cuba rerun ni sekali. And then you click sign out. Okay, lepas tu dia akan sign out lah. Hafiz sign out. Then when you want to sign in again, dia akan keluar ni. Choose an account. Okay, saya klik, saya sign in again. Okay, already sign in. And then want to sign out, click sign out. Okay, Hafiz sign out. So that's all. Okay, that's all how to create an application with sign in and sign out. So yang ni kalau nak ada space, tekan space lah kat sini. Oh, okay, tekan space. So when you press play, okay, sign in, and then press here. Okay, dia akan minta pilih account. Okay, sign in. And then nak sign out, tekan sign out kat sini. Alright, they sign out. Hafiz Gmail sign out. Okay, easy and simple, right? Okay, very easy, very simple way to create an authentication for your Android application. Next, we will look into other form of authentication. Okay, until then, be seeing you on the next lab segment.